Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 113 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 189 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 190. Question 190. You have an Azure subscription named Subscription 1 that contains two Azure virtual networks named VNet1 and VNet2. VNet1 contains a VPN gateway named VPN GW1 that uses static routing. There is a site-to-site VPN connection between your on-premises network and VNet1. On a computer named Client1 that runs Windows 10, you configure a point-to-site VPN connection to VNet1. You configure virtual network peering between VNet1 and VNet2. You verify that you can connect VNet2 from the on-premises network. Client1 is unable to connect VNet2. You need to ensure that you can connect Client1 to VNet2. What should you do? Let's create a diagram to visualize this question. Let's build up the diagram. As per question, we do have one Azure subscription, subscription 1, and subscription 1 contains two Azure virtual networks named VNet1 and VNet2. And definitely VNet1 and VNet2 would have some resources in it. Next part of the question is, VNet1 contains VPN gateway and that uses the static routing. Static routing uses small routing tables with only one entry for each destination. It also requires less computational time than dynamic routing because each route is pre-configured. Then the next part of the question says that there is site-to-site VPN connection between on-premise network and VNet1. Next is, on a computer named Client1 that runs Windows 10, you configure a point-to-site VPN connection to VNet1. After having the VPN client installed on the remote computer, point-to-site VPN tunnel is working. And then next part of the question is that you configure virtual network peering between VNet1 and VNet2. You verify that you connect to VNet2 from the on-premise network. We have configured the VNet to VNet peering and we have verified it that this peering is working from this remote site. That means we are able to connect to VNet1 and from there we were able to connect any resource in VNet2. Next part of the question is that the Client1 is unable to connect on VNet2, means the Client1 is able to connect on VNet1 but it is not able to reach the VNet2. As we have verified that from our side, connection is working perfectly with VNet2 but for some reason it is not working with the remote client computer. Therefore, it seems there should not be any issue with the peering, otherwise it would not have worked with the remote site. Also, a very important thing to note here is that we have set up the peering between VNet1 and VNet2 after installing the remote client and setting up point-to-site VPN connection between the Client1 and VNet1. Therefore, VPN client is not aware of the changes in the topology. Therefore, we will have to download and reinstall VPN client to remote computer to get it updated with new configuration on the Azure site. Let's go back to question. Therefore, you may have noticed that this question is divided into two parts. The first part where the Client1 has configured point-to-site VPN connection to VNet1. And later on, we configured the network peering between VNet 1 and VNet 2. That's why it is not reflecting on the client 1, because its VPN client is not reconfigured or updated. Therefore, option C, download and reinstall the VPN client configuration package on client 1 is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.